I'm Nadine Stillings. I'm the art therapist here at the Bedford VA, and we are at the opening art show for the 2019 National Veterans Creative Arts Festival and Competition. So currently we're in phase one of the competition, where veterans from each VA across the country submit artwork, creative writing, and performances in a multitude of categories. This is the visual arts portion of our show, and we are looking at about 43 pieces of work from veterans from different eras, from different service branches, and all of them have been generous enough to share their talents with us today.
Hi, today we're here with artist Bob Williams for the VA Performing Arts and Visual Arts Show. Bob, can you tell us a little bit about your painting here?
Sure. Generally, I'm a plein air painter, which means I paint outdoors with various groups. This one, however, is just out of the brain. So I like to paint in the studio, and in the wintertime, that's all I do. I just paint in the studio.
Excellent. So what media is this?
This is acrylic on canvas. And I work in acrylics generally because it dries quickly. It's not like an oil painting, you know, where you have to be careful not to smudge it for maybe a month.
And how long have you been painting?
How old am I? I've been painting all my life. I started out cartooning when I was 10 years old, and I'm now 83, so I've been painting a while.
Can you maybe tell us a little bit about your service?
Sure. I was going to be drafted, so I enlisted back in 1955, and I served in France and in Germany, and did 3 years, and that was it. I was a peacetime veteran.
Well, thank you so much for your service, and thank you for showing us your wonderful art today. Maybe you'll show us a few more of your other paintings? Okay, so we have another piece here by Bob Williams. This one is called The End of Gravity. Now, it looks like it's 3D to me, like it's sort of popping out. Can you tell me?
We call this an assemblage because it's oil color, but it's on foam board. So it's done in a 3D manner, and then the string. So there is a number of different elements, so we have to call it an assemblage.
Now, how long would something beautiful like this take you?
This was rather quick. This is like a one-day painting.
Really?
Yeah. I'd been thinking about it a long time, you know, the idea of what happens if gravity ends and continents start floating out of the ocean, you know.
So what was your interest in space that drew you to this?
Well, over the years, I've done different surrealistic things, and I'm just fascinated by the idea of space. So that's all. It was just an inspiration that I decided to do a couple weeks ago.
Well, I love it. I think it's a wonderful addition to this collection that we're displaying today. Thank you so much. So here we are at the VA Art Show, and we have a beautiful birdhouse here. Did you make this birdhouse?
Yes.
And what is your name?
Margaret Clessens.
Now tell me a little bit about this house. What inspired you to build this beautiful?
It's been so long since I made it that I forget all the particulars, because I've made about 8 birdhouses.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I don't know, you know, I don't have really when that happened. Yeah.
Now, did you make this by yourself?
No, I had a wonderful veteran help me. I was hoping he was down here today, so that if it won prizes, he would get the prize. That's why I come down.
You don't want the prize?
No, I want that guy to get it. He's wonderful.
That's very generous.
No, he was generous. Imagine doing that, going home and doing a little house like that, and all I did was paint it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Would you mind telling us a little bit about your service?
I was in the Army in World War II. And my brother was in the Army, and they had a big write-up on him in the Patriot paper in Charlestown. They found out he was a mystery flyer after all these years from a letter. Still in the Patriot if you want to look for it. And my father was in World War I, and he chased Pancho Villa. Yeah, yeah. So I remember when I went into the Army, my brother Billy wrote me a letter from Florida. He was in the big hotels down there. They took them over to train the pilots, and he says, get the out of there. He says, that's no place for you. And he was right.
Well, thank you so much for your service. And
taking your time to talk.
Yeah. Have you always been interested in creative arts, or is it something here at the VA that maybe inspired you to get started in creating?
Oh, definitely here, yeah. The help here. I don't know how anybody could say anything nasty about it, the veterans. I don't know. I mean, the help of the veterans, you can see yourself how wonderful they are. You see the little fellow there singing?
Right.
Summertime? Yeah. He's adorable, that guy.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us today. It's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure talking to you.
So right now I'm here with Steve Kowalasik, who's one of the featured artists here today. Steve, could you tell us a little bit about this painting up here called Into the Next Challenge?
Yes. Basically, what it is we're kind of like going through all the problems in my life. And I'm coming out of the fog of the last problem I had. And I'm seeing the challenge of the next problem, which is the mountain range. And the background is totally blacked out because I can't worry about the future. And I'm working on my next challenge, whichever that might be. I'm about ready to go into retirement, and that's my biggest fear right now, what's going to happen next. And that's what this painting kind of brought into my head and came and did what it had to do to have me move forward in life. And basically that's what the whole thing's about.
How long have you been an artist?
I've been painting like 30 years, which was actually my first challenge. It was my therapy and working towards recovery that I had just stepped into.
And this is a painting, but is it acrylic? What media?
It is oil. It is oil, and it's basically just done all out of my head, and not knowing what I'm doing next.
Would you mind telling us a little bit about your service?
It's my service, the military. I was in the Marine Corps, which was basically, I talked to a recruiter on a Monday, I had a physical on a Wednesday, and I was in Parris Island on a Friday.
Just like that.
A friend of mine got into trouble with the law, and he kind of talked me into it after he got out of boot camp. So basically what it turned into is that he sold me for 5 days extra leave.
Now you have another painting over here. Would you mind showing us this one?
Jupiter Sunset, not Jupiter's Sunset. It's basically just an oil color, oil painting on canvas, which is something that I recently got into. And, you know, I find it holds the colors a little bit more. And I was in one of my art groups painting it. And when I paint, I moved the painting around. And the guy across from me thought I was painting a picture of Jupiter. Uh-huh. So it kind of like, that's where I got the title from.
Now you use a lot of very muted colors, nothing very, very vibrant. Is there something that you could tell us about the color palette that you've chosen?
Well, it's kind of like just what's in front of me.
Yeah.
And it's just what I'm seeing in my head at the time and moving towards that, you know. A lot of it is just the thing that relaxes me the most is that there's 1,000 things in my mind and I'm kind of focusing on all of them at the same time, and you know, it's just part of my recovery process.
Now, as someone who's found a lot of success in art and using it as a therapy tool, what would you say to someone else who's never even thought about using art before? Would you recommend it?
I would highly recommend it. It clears the mind. It clutters the mind, and when those two things meet, that's your challenge being made right there.
Well, thank you for sharing with us today, and thank you also for your service.
Thank you.